In this video, we're going to walk through a proof of Theorem 14.9, which establishes both an upper bound and a lower bound on the chromatic number of a graph, both in terms of the independence number of a graph. So I want you to recall that the independence number of a graph is the order of a largest independent set of the graph. And remember, an independent set is a set of vertices that are mutually non-adjacent, no edges between them. And then also remember that in a proper coloring, the color classes, each of them, is an independent set, right? We can't have edges between vertices colored the same. So to illustrate what exactly we're doing with a chromatic, with finding the chromatic number, I want to turn to an example before we prove this to see how these concepts relate. So here I have a graph, and I want to think of this in terms of independent sets. So notice here, the independence number of the graph is 3. The best I can do is these 3 vertices is a maximum independent set. So I could color those all the same color, say 1. Then my color class of vertices colored 1, I'm calling V sub 1, so that's these vertices. My next largest independent set are these. And I'm just going to color these each 2. Right? Because it's an independent set, I can color them each the same color. Finally, I just have one vertex left. I'll color this V3. And so what we've done here is we've partitioned the vertex set into these color classes such that each color class is independent, is a way to think about this. Independence number gives us a bound on the biggest size of the color class, of any color class. So we'll be able to use that. But I want to point out something else. I'm going to add some colors to this. Sorry, look at what we did here with the colors. So what this is, what we have here, and actually what is the graph in question here? This is K3-2-1. It's a complete 3-partite graph, and it was 3-colorable. So what I want to say here is what we're actually doing is we're finding the smallest value k for which a graph is k-partite, because this is exactly what a partite graph is each partite set is independent. So that's one in a complete k-partite graph. Each partite set is independent. And we can say it can be colored the same. Just assign the same color to every vertex in the partite set. And so what this says is that if G is k-partite, if it's possible to split it up into k-partite sets, then G is k-colorable. Finally, if G is k-colorable, what happens here? Then, so we have a coloring. Right, let's see. Let me not define that. We know what the coloring's domain codomain are. Let C be a K coloring with color classes V1, V2, up through VK. These are my color classes. Then what that gives me, right, I would have V1, I'd have V2. So I'm just going to lay out my graph like this, V3, up through some V sub K. And each color class is independent. So what that means is there can't be any edges between these color classes. And so any edge must go between color classes. Right? And this is exactly what a k-partite graph is. It's one that can be partitioned into these k-partite sets such that no edges in between vertices the same. And so that says that if G is k-colorable, then it is k-partite. So k-colorable, that's the title of this slide, k-colorable if and only if k-partite. That's really the idea of colorings, is finding the chromatic number then is the smallest value k for which a graph is k-partite. So, right, the k-partite graphs are exactly the k-colorable graphs. All right, how does this relate back up to independence? So Let's try for just sort of an easy bound using the independence number. So, all right, sorry, back and forth. I'm going to refer to this. Yeah, this is inequality 1 and inequality 2. So let's see. Inequality 1, let's just think about, so here we're going to let v1, v2, vk be the color classes in a k equal to, so let's actually give it with the best possible color and using the fewest number of colors. Let's say k is equal to the chromatic number of g. So coloring of g. So remember, each v sub I is independent. Independent. So v sub I is at most alpha of g for each I. Right? Because alpha of g is the size of the biggest independent set. And you can't have an independent set with more vertices than that. How do we get this result? All we do is we add up the vertices. So n, the total number of vertices we could get by summing up the v sub i's, I equal 1 to k. But each v sub I is at most the independence number. So I'm really adding the independence number up. K times, but k is the chromatic number of g. So I'm adding this up. Sorry, I tried to write a chi of g. And so what do I get? I get that this is alpha of g times the chromatic number of g. Right? At best, I have a chromatic number of g many independent sets of the maximum possible size. This would happen in a complete k-partite graph. A balanced complete k-partite graph, rather. And so what does this tell us? Well, let's just divide over independence number of g, and we see that the chromatic number of g is at least n over alpha of g. So there's our lowest bound. So next, for inequality 2, what do we do here? Well, there's another way I can come up with a k coloring of the graph. So at worst, I peel off a maximum independent set, and then the rest of the vertices are all complete. So that is, if my independent set here, let's say this is u, and it's an independent set, and let's say this is the biggest one. So the cardinality of u is exactly equal to the independence number of g. Well, at worst, the rest of my graph, it's independent here. This is all independent. But maybe the rest of the graph forms a kn minus alpha of g, n minus alpha of g minus 1, plus 1 vertices would be here, right? I have alpha of g here. Right. So I could do it now. So there are n minus alpha of g vertices there. But the idea is now I can use one color for this entire independent set, and then at worst I'd have to use another n minus alpha of g colors. So that would give me a total of n minus alpha of g plus 1 colors. So I'll let u equal k1. And each vertex. So this just, in general, right, that might not be complete. This is just a bound. So in general, this is g minus u, right? This is the vertex set of g minus u, each vertex. So we assign one color to u. So u here is a maximum independent set. What do I have here? U equals K1. I don't know what I meant So, right, what I mean is color each vertex of U. Oh, I know what I mean. U is V, yeah, V1. Not K1. U is V1, our first color class. And each vertex, V of G minus U, color distinctly. Then we have a, what is it? We needed one for the independent set, and then we needed n minus alpha of G. 1 plus n minus alpha of G, coloring of G. So, since we have a coloring, chromatic number of G is at most n minus alpha of G. And that proves both inequalities. All right, so let's see an example of this in action in how we can determine how we determine chromatic numbers of graphs. So here, let's just figure out. So n is 10 here. We have 10 vertices. Independence number, well, okay, I have a 5 cycle here. The best I can do in terms of independence number is 2. I can take any 2 independent vertices here, and that's the best I can do in the 5 cycle. And then same thing at the other 5 cycle, best I can do is 2. And let's see if I take 2 vertices, how about this one and this one, and up to automorphism, these 2 vertices, this selection is, we can assume it's these two without loss of generality. And that's adjacent, the pair of those, the only vertex we could add into this. Let's see, are there any vertices we can add into this? Where's my alpha of g exactly 2? Yeah, the best I can do is 2. Alpha is equal to 2 here. So we could either take those two, or we could take maybe, say, this one this one. We could also take those in an independent set. But that's the best we can do. Okay. I also want you to recall that omega of G is the clique number. Remember, this is the size of a maximum complete graph in the graph. And that's omega of G. So omega here is equal to biggest complete subgraph is 4 vertices. So omega of G is equal to 4. And remember that the chromatic number of G is, we need to use at least 4 colors because of that complete subgraph. So from that, from omega of G, we get that the chromatic number is at least 4. Let's see what we get from the independence number. And that comes from these previous 2 theorems. So n over alpha is 5. And so what that tells us is we have to actually, this gives us a little bit more information than the clique number. This tells us we actually have to use 5. We actually have to use 5 color classes because the best we can do in each independent set is 2. Finally, as an upper bound, let's see what's the worst we can do. That's n minus alpha plus 1. That's, ooh. So let's say n minus alpha plus 1. That's 9. And so that's an upper bound on the chromatic number. So at worst, we're going to have to use 9. Oftentimes, though, and we'll see this in an upcoming video, this n minus alpha plus 1, it's not always such a great bound, especially in this case, because I think we can get a 5 coloring here. So this is my best bound now for a lower bound, and let's see if we can actually get 5. So I'm going to so start with one of these K4s, and I'm going to color it, let's say 1, 2, 3, 4. One, two, three, four, and then I'm going to see what's forced and just go from there. So these two I could color, say, 2 and 1. That would be okay. And then maybe I could color these 3 and 4. But that wouldn't be That wouldn't be good, because then I'd have to color those 2 and 1. So I'm not going to be able to do it there. I'm going to go back. I made a choice somewhere that wasn't good. Well, so, okay, so this one's adjacent to a 3 and a 4, so actually I have to color this either 1 or 2. We have a fifth color class we can use. I'm going to color this 1 and 2. And then I want to be able to get my other color class in here, so I'm going to color this 5 and can I use 3? No. I want to save 3 and 4 for over here. 1, 2, let's do 3. 4. I'm stuck again, aren't I? All right, I'm going to go back. So I had to color those like this. And I have to do... Chromatic number is 6 here. So, yeah, I could use 5 early on here. Yeah, let's do that. I'm going to color this one 5. I'm going to use 5 early on. I have 1 and 5. And what can I do here? Maybe say 3 and 2. And now this leaves open the possibility, right? 2, 3. I can do 4 and 5 here. The 1 and 2 won't. Good. That's the idea. So think about, like, if you think of this graph as a bunch of K4s that are that have identified edges in sort of this C5 fashion, right? We have 1, 2, 3, 4. We have 1, 3, 4, 5. We're looking at four-element subsets of a five-element set, and we are arranging them way. That'll have to be different. Okay. So what this means, here's a 5 coloring, right? That's a 5 coloring of G. And so that gives us chi of G is at most 5. So what we have here is a 5 chromatic graph. That's it for this video.